authorities are still working to identify the virus behind a pneumonia outbreak in the central city of Wuhan.
The coronavirus is the biggest threat this country has faced for decades, and this country is not alone. All over the world, we're seeing the devastating impact of this invisible killer.
We're just off to Amsterdam, sunny Amsterdam. We're gonna go and have a chill, the birthday weekend.
Just a few more minutes and we'll be getting on the train to Amsterdam Central.
I'm gonna be moving on very soon. I'm gonna go and get into my digs and then I'm meeting Gremlin and Strain Cainers.
I can see him walking down, here he is. Gremlin Tattoo. First time I've met this lad, you know. First time I've met him.
How are you doing, brother? Are you good, sir? Are you good? Are you well? Here he is.
Wait.
Gremlin.
And what is the barrier up or down that you got there?
Crack of people. We're just waiting for Strain Cainers to turn up.
There's only Strain Cainers going to approach Amsterdam like he does.
There. Should not have done that.
Come on.
There he is. There he is.
Easy. Okay, it's just come out of the 420 coffee shop. Relax. We're gonna need to relax after this walk, mate. We're gonna walk to Easytimes by now.
Morning, peeps. It's day two, full day today. I'm just gonna show you my view from the balcony. Oh yeah, this is probably the best one yet. It is day two in Amsterdam. It's going to be wake and bake going somewhere in the coffee shop. As predicted, Denz is still in bed over there. He's knackered, he ain't getting up yet. We're going to go to Mr. K & Co about 11 o'clock in the morning. One of the coffee shops I've been looking forward to. But I'm going to go find somewhere else for a little wake and bake. Where would I go? There's only one way to find out. We're going to hit the streets and go searching. Sorry for the view. I just cut to a better view, really.
Right, let's get outside. A bit pissed off because I can't find the hair gel. I did bring it, it's just gone missing. Fuck the hair. Let's go get stoned.
About 8:30, 9 o'clock-ish, about 8:45, I'd say. In Amsterdam, this is one of my favourite parts. Just getting up, floating around, looking for somewhere to have a nice coffee. I really could do with a coffee. And obviously, even more so, do with a nice wake and baker. Where are we gonna go? We're gonna head to Easytimes. Hopefully, I've got directions here.
15 minute walk. Gotta pick up the pace a little bit. There's only 16 minutes walk, and I've been walking for 5 minutes. So how does that work out?
Even with Google Maps, I'm still getting lost. It's not too far.
I know you guys are thinking, is he still not at Easytimes? No, I'm not. 70 metres away, 1 minute walk from Easytimes coffee shop. See, rerouting, even though I've not gone off track.
This is what I mean, how hard is this? Well, people say it was too far. Last night, Grem was saying it was really, really far. It weren't that far. We walked further to go to that coffee shop relax, which I didn't really think too much of. So we walked a bit further than I was hoping to go to somewhere that I didn't really want to go to. But we are going to head to Easytimes now. I've been hearing the weed is banging here. I need to check some of my messages for some of my viewers that said, try Easytimes, try Easytimes. We are going to try Easytimes if we can find it. Wish me luck, let's go. Okay, so Tom Thomas took me out of my way again, you know what I mean? This is not my fault. I'm not even that stoned. Some of you are watching this because you want a guide through Amsterdam. Well, this is what not to do. I've gone off route again. Don't trust technology. Don't trust yourself. Trust the locals. She said, down here, not the first one, but the next turning on the right. And we're at Easytimes. Easytimes, more like hard times. Fucking hard times. Right, she's definitely said the next one, not the first turning, but the next one. There's a tram stop. There's a tram stop there. Tom has no idea what he's talking about. In my last Amsterdam vlog, it was search for the plug. This has definitely been a search for Easytimes. Here we go. Kosher, yeah? Should get 2 grams then, yeah, it's kosher. What else? What else you got? I might get one another. The purple kosher. Anything else you can recommend?
Purple kosher,
very nice. Could you go 2 grams with the kosher right now, please?
Yep.
Yeah, lovely. Thank you. London pound cake as well. Can I check the London pound cake? Look at this. This is the London pound cake. That looks amazing. And we've got the kosher there. Can we get 2 pounds of, so 2 grams of the London pound cake? Yeah.
No kosher?
No kosher as well. Yeah, we go for them. Last night I was going around the main parts and my mates are taking me here and there and I wasn't satisfied with the weed. I was just buying a gram because I wasn't too sure. But this is definitely the stuff, so. Alright, I've got the weed here. Just go take a look at this. Looks like I'm the first one here. I got it quite early. Looking nice, looking very, very snazzy, modern actually. Look at this. Literally just me here right now. So, someone definitely mentioned the Kosher Kush at Easytimes. Here it is. Oh, that is what I needed. That is definitely what I needed. Compared to the stuff I was smoking yesterday, this is so much better. Oh, your star, thank you. That's amazing, thanks a lot. This is the Kosher Kush that someone definitely recommended me go. And also Sticky, loved the Kosher Kush when he was over in Dan. I don't know if he got it from Easytimes, but here it is. Also, someone definitely mentioned the London Pound as well. Get the London Pound, okay, they said. Never had London pound cake before. Have you smoked London pound cake? I've smoked the kosher before. I can't remember where I've smoked that from. I think back somewhere in Essex I've smoked this. Not the London pound cake. Oh, I think we're going to go for the London pound cake for wake and bake. Let's do it. So I found Easytimes. Took me ages to find this place. Ages, but it has definitely been worth it. If you've not been Easytimes, this is definitely a place to check out. And I've not even smoked the weed yet. I can just tell this is banging. Decent price as well. Altogether cost me 60 for 4 grams, 2 grams of the pound and 2 grams of the Kush as well. Light is not the best yet, peeps, so it's not gonna look too good. This is done. I didn't go for the sativas at all. I don't know what actually this is. I'm guessing it's like a hybrid, this one, but this is done us already. This is only going to kill us even more. Maybe I should have gone with a sativa. Nah. Let me know if you're sativa or an indica. Let us know below. Here's always a good test of how I like the coffee shop or how I don't like the coffee shop. Does Riz like it? Does he not like it? I buy out a second drink. It's always a good sign. You're going to stay here a bit longer. Oh, thank you so much. Cheers. Ta. Okay, that is done me, but we are going to smoke this as well now. We're going to try the Kosher Kush. Pick up all the crew that did say, try the Kosher Kush at Easytimes. I'm about to try it.
You smoke, Paul? No, I don't. Me neither. I don't smoke cigarettes. I don't smoke cigars. I don't smoke a pipe.
I've smoked a reefer.
As I do, I leave things somewhere and look, guess what I've lost? My glasses. Now, when I asked for directions around the corner to find Easytimes, must have left my glasses. I was checking the footage, yeah, and I had my glasses just before that, and I've gone in there, and when I've come out, I didn't have my glasses, so I must have left them on the side. Fingers crossed the bar girl has seen them and just put them to the side. Apparently it's just round here. Fuck my life. We've got the glasses back. They were where I thought they were. Got that, playing all the videos back. Oh no, I'm just talking. Oh no, I'm filming. Yeah, ignore me. I'm weird. See, I've put all the video back and it all made sense that I left my glasses here when I was asking for directions to Easytimes. It's only around the corner, come back and here they are waiting for me. Rewarding myself with a beer. We've met up with our translator, Grem, as well. How are we doing, Grem?
Well, good.
That's a hello.
No, good morning. I'm very good.
Oh, very good. Yeah. I was just testing you. I knew that. Yeah. we're gonna find some more phrases. In fact, we're gonna do another phrase right now. What do you say for help, please? I'm lost. I've been walking around this place for a long time.
You can only use you that much.
Okay. Help, I'm lost. Please help me.
I just lost. I can't get the word out of my mouth. I'm lost.
Just help lost would probably do, wouldn't it? The key words.
Help. Help is just a help. It's not even like in English.
Oh, really? Yeah. So you just say help.
Help. Yeah.
So if I shout help, yeah, right, good. Okay, right. Help,
can,
there you go.
Can you my help? Can you help me? Can you my help?
Okay, so how would you say, how do you find, and then you could put insert coffee shop there or anything there. How do you find?
Who comes to a coffee shop?
And then you put the coffee shop afterwards.
Yeah. Op sunka coffee shop. You can say as well, op sunka coffee shop. I'm looking for a coffee shop.
How do you say this waffle is not good enough? I want free ice cream.
I have friends first.
What's that?
Friends first.
Friends first. What is this,
yeah,
coffee shop?
Yeah, but it's also got quite a good name to itself. It's got very more for the youngster and the locals come here.
So yeah, Graham used to live here for about 4 years. You said, didn't you?
Yeah.
And in that time, did you go to quite a few coffee shops, or did
not
you stick
really,
to
because
ones
I had,
you liked?
I stuck with the one I worked with, and then I had friends.
Oh, friend! Best friends forever and ever! Oh, friend!
So, never even really went to coffee shops. It's only really something I've been doing in the last couple of years.
So we just come out of this place, what was it called again? Remind me.
Happy.
Coffee shop, happy feelings. I'm feeling happy about this. This is cherry cookies, peeps. Is that a tattoo there?
Yeah.
Self-made tattoo. Yeah.
Tattoos in the hands nearly don't stay for very long. If you don't tattoo it deep enough, they fall out.
So. And you got a pre-roll here of
orange goat.
And what else should we pick up?
Elephant Kush.
Oh yes, we've got a mixture. We've got an indica, or was it a hybrid actually, I think?
Hybrid.
Yeah, hybrid, yeah. I'm really interested in what this cherry is like. Cherry Kush apparently is the most popular one on the menu. They wouldn't let us film in there, so obviously we didn't film.
Smell that or...
Yeah. All massive buds on that one, weren't they?
Yeah. You might think
you smoke, Paul? No, I don't. Me neither. I don't smoke cigarettes. I don't smoke cigars. I don't smoke a pipe. I don't smoke the reefer.
Alright, should go meet up with Denz, see where he is.
Yeah.
How do people, and welcome back to the second half of the Amsterdam 2020 video. It's, what day is it, Thursday?
Isn't it a bit weird? You can buy pre-rolls with tobacco and smoke them in a coffee shop, but as soon as you make a joint with tobacco, it's not allowed.
Yeah, some of you will be thinking, what is the rule with tobacco? It's got a lot more strict, I'd say the rules are a lot more stricter with the tobacco rules since the COVID-19. People are saying that the further you go out, the more relaxed it is. We've smoked tobacco with our spliffs in every single coffee shop.
With no problem.
Ooh, you're hard, showing off.
I think the rule is, don't be blatant about it. Don't be obvious about it. Don't take a piss about it.
It's made with cigarette fucking tobacco as well. Oh, fuck's sake. Look, it's not even burning.
I never get the pre-rolls.
Garbage. Garbage.
I never get the pre-rolls. Maybe a good video
even
would be
when I work
the best
for the
pre-rolls.
We just used to take the actual sugar leaf to make pre-rolls. There was no bud or kief or anything. It was just sugar leaf. Garbage.
It was at this moment that he knew. He fucked up.
What a good fucking shithole. How much tobacco? You can't even look at it.
It does look like a lot of tobacco in this.
And it's like almost like pipe kind of tobacco.
We were wondering how much this fucking cheese is. Look, I mean, we were talking like, what family goes through this much cheese? It's got to be a lot of money. I was thinking about 100 bloody euros. No, only 10 euros. $9.99.
20 kilos of cheese.
Look at that. That is a lot of cheese.
Look at this, even a bigger block there.
No, that's like weights.
I'm not sure where Strain Cainers is, out and about somewhere. I've just tried to get hold of Gremlin. I can't get hold of him.
So we're on our way to Denz. You stocked up, I've stocked up. Denz is old, he can't be walking too far in Amsterdam. We did a lot of walking yesterday. It's probably knackered him out a little bit. He was aching.
Yeah.
So he's a Coffeeshop by Beefer.
I'm
not too far from the Bulldog probably, I think, is it? Probably right around the corner. I've been there before. Me and Sticky went there during our first visit to Amsterdam together. Have you been to a Coffeeshop by Beefer? Have you been to Coffeeshop Easytimes? Have you smoked a pre-roll? Do you buy pre-rolls in Amsterdam?
Is that the first one you've ever smoked pre-rolls?
No, I've had a few pre-rolls before. Sticky's bought a few pre-rolls.
That's probably all.
I think they're hit and miss, aren't they?
That's shit.
I think it's like the space cakes, pre-rolls, space cakes, they're hit and miss.
Yeah.
And that is it with the city, with the coffee shops. It is a lot of hit and miss, but I think that's part of the fun, the adventure
when
of going around searching.
The tourist areas, you'll find it. When you start going out of it, you'll not find this problem. That's the thing.
This is a cheese. Oh, it's not real. Oh. Damn it.
Grow your own weed again.
What are you growing now?
Yeah, you've got seeds and soil, everything in it.
There's a gift for the kids.
You're for your grandma.
Big up Yankee Smokes. It's always nice to have a pair of marijuana socks. Which one would you get? How'd you say, will these cakes get me high? Will these cookies get me high?
Sell the cookies for my work, Mark.
There you go, guys.
Fucking garbage.
Okay, another survival tip.
Zebra crossings are completely different to in England. You don't have to wait for them, you just walk. Before, it doesn't matter how far the car is, just walk across them, because that is your right to cross. So don't, like in England, wait for the car, just go.
In
you don't knock you over, you get a lot of money.
Oh, right, okay, that's not so. I was going to say, there's a bit of a risk here, yeah, so you're just going to assume they are going to stop for you.
No, no,
is that,
they have
for the trams as well?
No, the trams won't.
Okay, so trams, the trams will.
Cars and bicycles.
Will hit and run. The trams will hit and run.
Yeah, yeah.
But cars will allow you to live, apparently. But yeah, and if they do injure you, or worse, you're going to get a payout for yourself or your family.
Yeah, but then you get to shoot at the. Amsterdam City sues the person who hit you as well, so you get more money.
So you get money from the council and you get money from the guy that hit
or girl? From the city and from the guy.
So, or girl? Lawyers. Or girl?
Yeah, or girl, yeah.
If it's a driver, it probably won't be a girl.
Or a transsexual, it is Amsterdam.
Yeah, yeah, anything goes.
It is a nice this day in Amsterdam.
How'd you say? It's such a nice day, isn't it, today?
It is. Heel, gelukkig, bedankt. What would you say? It's a prachtig gedaan. So if you want to use a normal Dutch, it's a bit harder. If you just want to use slang, just say it's a prachtig gedaan.
How'd you say, it's my birthday today, can I get free weed?
Dit is mijn verjaarsdag vandaag, kan ik... vrijdag weed krijg.
That's so easy to remember. Done. That's all you need to know. It's my birthday. Shit.
This is my verjaardag. Ik zoek weed. Just say it's my birthday. I want weed.
Yeah. I'm sure that's gonna work.
No, that won't work. They'll kick you out the coffee shop. You fucking ignorant cunts.
Okay, how'd you say, I said cappuccino, not coffee, bitch.
I soup for a cappuccino, me a coffee, ni yo hoor. Because there's no real bitch.
That sounds like whore.
Yeah, because in Dutch, they don't real swear words. It's more like diseases, cancer, and syphilis and shit like that. This is swear words. They don't have fuck, cunts, and shit like that.
They don't have fuck?
No, they don't.
There's no fucking in
no,
Dutch.
No, they say kanker, kanker layer. In Dutch, it's all diseases and viruses kind of shit.
Oh, God, right.
Yeah. So in the next couple of years, coronavirus will be in the Dutch swear word category.
Yeah. So people will be, if you want to slag someone off, just call them coronavirus.
Yeah. Because, I mean, as it is, you say to someone when you say...
You fucking COVID.
We in English say you fucking cunt, but here they say you have fucking cancer.
You've got cancer.
Layer. You're dying from cancer.
Guys, you can be fine in Amsterdam. Listen to us. Don't worry. We're getting all the bases covered, apart from we're going the wrong way. Yeah, that's the thing, I've always said that before. If you talk too much, you will get slightly off track. And slightly off track can very quickly lead to completely off track.
We've got to start your day with a nice fresh fruit punch of something. You know, keep your energy going for walking about. It's the only fucking problem in Amsterdam. Even though you don't want to walk, you still walk. It's bloody ridiculous.
There's lots and lots of cake shops around here. You can easily munch out, but don't worry, you'll be burning off them calories from walking the streets of Amsterdam.
My phone keeps on telling me I have to stand still to get the GPS to work.
What?
Yeah, look. And now I stand still. And
nothing.
Oh, now I start working. Now I start working. And it's all.
Well, look, at least we know it's up that way a bit, don't we? So.
There's a stupid Ned Hunters over there.
Yeah, I think that's the one I've been to actually. In fact, if that's Hunters, isn't the greenhouse Namast around here? Is this greenhouse Namast around this way, maybe?
I think so.
Oh, I don't believe anything I say. But yeah, we've been to that place before.
me and Sticky went now. I'm trying to think what I've got now. I think I might have got the Super Silver, the G13. I think it was the G13. Yeah. You're saying Hunters maybe gone downhill a little bit. Hunters was all the rage, wasn't it? Everyone was talking about Hunters.
Yeah, 10 years ago.
Don't really hear much of Hunters now.
No.
Have you been to Hunters? Have you been recently? Did you used to go and haven't been before? Let us know below. Have you ever been lost in Amsterdam? I'm sure a lot of you have been lost in Amsterdam. Please let us know in the comments section. I'm sure
if you haven't, you're lying. Even me, I've lived here for 4 years and I still get lost.
Has anyone not been lost in Amsterdam? Has everyone got it absolutely perfect, their geography? Surely not. Slight problem. I thought Dr. Denz said Coffeeshop Ibiza. We've been walking to Coffeeshop Ibiza. We've been getting lost trying to get to Coffeeshop Ibiza. We've just found out he didn't say Coffeeshop Ibiza.
What day is it? Thursday. Early morning Thursday. I'm at Coffeeshop Reefer.
Coffeeshop Reefer.
So now we are changing our direction. We're heading back to where we were almost. To Coffeeshop Reefer.
I'll just show you where I am. I'll flip that camera around and show you where I am. Yeah, I'm just shat. I'm just shat at Coffeeshop Reefer.
Fuck my life.
Well, I'm going to meet you at Reefer then.
Yeah, we're going Coffeeshop Reefer.
Alright, cool. I will see you in a minute then.
See all you right, in a cool. minute.
Alright, alright. Ta-ta.
Oops.
Reefer, Ibiza. Fucking English.
Reefer, Ibiza, you know what I mean? You can see where I'm coming from. You can see the mistake that was made.
No, I understand it, but that's also the English accent. Coming off the northerner.
Yeah.
Ibiza, Reefer. Fucking northern accents.
Ah, but not just any old food, Jerry. Proper food. Scampi, chicken kebs, garlic bread.
Garlic bread?
I do like this place because it's got a lovely outside smoking area, all barred off and stuff like that. So if you ever come here and you want to sit outside and chill and smoke, because most coffee shops are all indoor, aren't they? And again, if you're a tobacco smoker, this is a fantastic coffee shop. So Coffeeshop Reefer, it's in an excellent spot. I'll just give you, I like to just sit about me when I'm on my own, sit about and watch people, you know what I mean? So that's what I'm doing. This is where I am. It's an absolute beautiful spot. It's a real nice coffee shop. It's been here for, I don't know, 20 years, something like that. It's been here for a long time, it has.
And there you go, landscape shot done.
This is the Amstel River. So the Dam River.
Like the beer?
Yeah, where the name of the city comes from, because it was the Amstel River, then they dammed it, and they called it Amsterdam.
Yeah,
Because the Amstel River was dammed for Amsterdam.
Yeah, I'm quite sure there is greenhouse damask right around here.
Yeah.
Yeah, 100%. So this is the greenhouse, the mast. This was a really good one. I actually did really like this one. You saw it in the Moon Rocks for Breakfast video.
Just looking at places that we were lost last night.
Walls everywhere.
There's a greenhouse right there. This is the background, so the background. Imagine the whole school just went off.
My God,
it's the most quieter one, and not many tourists come here. I actually think it is actually one of the nicest streams.
We got there really early. We got there when it opened, but we got there just before it opened. Well, so we're the first ones in. I like no that. You can get to talk to the staff when you get there early.
Yeah.
And you just got more. They got more time with you. You get your seating area where you want. Just chill. And get your bearings.
With COVID now, it's a little bit more difficult. Where before they will still have a talk with you, but you can't have a look at the weed and smell the weed or anything, which is a bit off-putting because you want to smell what you want to smoke.
Yeah, that's the thing you're going to find when you're over here right now, post-COVID. A lot of the places won't let you smell the buds. You can see the bud there, get it out, you can look at it, you can't just grab hold of it, you can't put it to your nose.
Now we're gonna, now I'm gonna show you how this works. Okay, look, there's cars going that way, cars going this way, come.
Whoa. Okay, this is a survival tip, crossing
see,
the road.
The cars are there, come, just walk. They have to wait.
So I'm not going to wait, I'm just going to go. And they do stop, they do stop.
Yeah, they have to. They have to,
they have to, otherwise, yeah, it's...
I know they have to.
So it's not because they don't want to hurt you, they probably do want to hurt you, but they can't afford to
no,
hurt
they're not
you.
English.
They can't afford to hurt you.
Yeah.
That side, we're going
this way.
Alright. Huh. I've got my guide here, this is his one job. No, two jobs, translate and find the coffee shops.
You're fine.
I don't smoke cigarettes. I don't smoke cigars.
That's a lovely bit about me.
You should go around me this time, yeah?
No, that's yours.
Oh, what?
Hammy, how dare you? This is the Kosher Kush.
Let's have a look.
That's the Kosher.
Oh, that's a nice bit of hammy. That's a bit more woody hammy, is that one.
For some reason, Denz is saying every strain he's getting...
What's that?
Every strain he's getting right now is hammy, apparently.
That smells like... if that's a black demeanor, I'm going to go fully because that smells like sausage casserole.
No, it's a Rebel OG.
That fucking...
Oh, Denz not what you're talking about.
Let's have a look at that one.
Rebel OG.
What's that one? London Poundcake.
It's lovely, mate. It's lovely. It? Lovely. Distinctive. Distinctive.
That smells way different to...
Lovely bit. It's just... It's lovely more of a dulled out hammy, that. that's not London Poundcake.
What you just said is one of the most insanely idiotic things I have ever heard. At no point in your rambling, incoherent response were you even close to anything that could be considered a rational thought.
That's not zombie. Thickens, I mean, that's not Kosher Kush.
The famous focus.
Do you think, well, look at that one, to that. It's fucking a little bit darker, but what's the growing techniques in them? You can tell they're outside growing them.
What do you reckon?
But yeah, that's supposed to be Kosher Kush.
Easytimes cannabis.
No, he's supposed to be Kosher Kush.
Well, I'm going to smoke some of this, mate.
That doesn't look anything like DNA's Kosher Kush.
Everyone in this room is now dumber for having listened to it. I award you no points, and may God have mercy on your soul.
Where's the calyx? There's always a big fat calyx. It's
slagging up the strains. No. Strain slag.
Oh, what are you doing?
I put that there for
you. I didn't realise you put my passport on top of it.
I didn't put your passport on top of it.
What's that one?
Oh, no.
Cherry pie?
That's the best one. I can smell it.
So we're about to try it now.
Yeah.
I can smell that. That's the best one at lot.
Yeah. I got that. And then I got that Rebel OG.
Oh, you want to see my shoreline?
You post on my field.
Where'd you get that from?
Some bloke, some tramp on the sea. Can't get it anywhere. I've been all over the like that, it's gone.
Where is it? Yeah. Where's the other one?
I mean, when you went in to relax last night, I really do appreciate what she did. She could have just got the jar.
Cherry cookies, yeah.
She could have just got the jar with all the dust and said, oh, this I'm sure. Yeah.
I don't smoke cigarettes. I don't smoke cigars. And smoke a pipe.
Hey everybody, I hope you're enjoying the show. Now shut the fuck up and watch this ad like your life depends on it. Which it does. Yours, the cheese. Only available for a limited time from Strain Busters. Buy the t-shirt, or you can expect a visit from Fernando. I'm the cheese! Ha 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 ha. Just like me, these t-shirts, they like to move. Are you gonna move? T-shirts, everybody needs. And if you say you don't, then get out of my face, you little punk.
I don't smoke the reefer.
Yeah. I picked myself some cherry pie and some Rebel OG.
What have you just got drinking?
This is the cherry cookies here, we're just having it now.
Is that what you have in there now?
The whole gram this from more or less.
Yeah.
Cherry cookies.
Come on, spark it up quick then, and then I can do it. Put my arm down, my arm's fucking aching.
Okay, yeah, fair enough.
My arm's well aching, yeah.
Getting old, man.
I know, it's no good. It's no good. Just let them know what the taste is. What, I'm not even smoking anything at the minute. I'm going to have another Melonade. Start the day with another Melonade. I'm not starting today, I've already started a day, fucking 2 hours ago or something.
Ooh.
Time is it?
Yeah, I've been awake, so I don't know what time I've been awake.
Got a light, quickly gas there.
Let's have a right little taste, right quick. Mm. Again, Amsterdam, it's fantastic. We can, we puff past it again, aren't we? It's back like the old days.
Yeah. This is Amsterdam, not England.
Here we go, he's going to slag it off and say it's
no,
Amy.
I'm just going to say it's quite nice, isn't it? I'm not going to lie, there's a lot of things taste very much like amnesia out here at the minute. Quite pleased with that. We'll give Greg verdict and then we'll call it a day. Well, not call it a day, but...
That's it, we go home now, go
we're going to fuck off home. We're going to fuck off
home. That strong.
Yeah. You tell we can't smoke anymore.
Sorry?
Roll inside, wick tobacco. Okay.
Yeah.
Just being told again, people, even though you are outside, you've got to add your tobacco, things like that. You know what I mean? She'll tell you. Okay. Well, I can't get it on. Here we go. I didn't realise outside, you know. I thought outside you was okay.
Stupid rules. You can smoke, but you cannot roll.
Well, do you? Is that right? You can smoke outside. No, there you go. You can smoke your tobacco joints outside,
yes,
people.
You can.
But you can't roll your tobacco joints outside.
Right.
Oh, that's a weird one, isn't it? Bloody hell. Right, people, I'll be back with you soon anyway. My arm's aching that buggy. I'll be back in a minute.
Remember, take your backy off the table. I've done that so many times, innit? How many times I've done that since being here?
Well, this is
every
I'm
coffee
you.
Shop. Right. We can't use that, so. Better hide that.
I think most coffee shops seem to be quite liberal about it, but when you're flaunting it, when you're flaunting it and putting it in the face, then they're like,
she even came
off.
Through the
coast. So that's the thing, that I'm going to go and make a joint inside then.
This is the cherry cookies, isn't it?
Yeah.
Really nice, actually, yeah. Yeah, satisfying. What else you purchased from here? What else you get? You got something else, didn't you? You got the elephant?
Rebel.
No, that was the other one, wasn't it? You didn't get the elephant there, did you? You got the Rue Boy, Drew, yeah. Friendly staff. Let's film in there a little bit. I've actually got no battery left in the GoPro, so we're going to leave that alone right now. But don't worry, Raw Rizzler,
one thing
using the phone.
About her as well, she actually had the weed in a bag so she could squeeze it so you could smell it, which was quite nice.
Have you just got it from out of it in there?
No.
Well, the same in there.
A coffee shop, yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, coffee shop, some of them, they open up the band, they give it a little squeeze. That's probably a sample bag, isn't it?
Yeah.
So.
You've been here a long time as well. 30 years you've been here in this place. And she's worked here. I said, you've been here a long time.
I thought you were saying you've been here 30 years. I was like, fuck me, we did get lost. Jesus, fucking hell. What journey did you take us down?
I don't think I'll be sat here 30 years, mate.
Just a skeleton. Just be a skeleton with a spliff there like that.
I'm just going to shit my pants again.
Shitty Denz, oh my god.
Yeah, Shitty Denz.
Nice little scenery, actually, it's nice little spot.
Beautiful, crooked house.
Yeah, the smoke house.
That is crooked, isn't it? That house is crooked. Crooked house, definitely crooked house. Denz recommends this place, let's go check it out.
Oh, yeah, please, just a little bit, please, thank you. This is when I say there's one thing I always look forward to when I come to Amsterdam, And it's weird, I know when my age is when I'm getting old, because the cannabis side of it becomes a secondary thing.
This shop. What's it called, your shop?
Amsterdam,
cheese deli.
Amsterdam, cheese deli.
They're
easy people. Easy. Not a problem.
You got no free
samples. I'm used to little sample things. My mouth is so dry now. That was a mistake.
Of course, yeah, it all makes sense. The coronavirus has stopped cheese raiding. All makes sense. There's a difference in Amsterdam. No cheese samples for me to stuff on my mouth, for them to expand.
Come and get some of this food, people.
It's absolutely stunning.
Shut up, Denz.
And once again, people, don't forget, hit the subscribe button.
Okie doke.
Ta-da.
Guys, we've struck gold. Denz delivers once again. We was thinking, can you get extracts here? Can you get extracts in here? Can you get a close up of that? Oh shit! Whoa!
Better not fucking drop that.
Oh, by the way, we've got a little crew that sort of built up now. We've got a few followers, a few viewers that just met up with us. So it's nice to see. We've got a nice little gang now.
Joining us. Seeing Cainers, look at state of you. You look stone
down. Go on now, we're all there.
So mashed, you look. I reckon Spain kid is going to throw a white egg in a minute. As the tickle comes.
So what is this?
Frosty gelato.
So here it is, guys, the moon rocks. Peeps, risen from Strain Cainers here. Who else is going to be? Do you know what? I've just finished the episode. It's more or less done now. I've got to just check and make sure there's no errors. There's probably going to be a load of errors, but it does take me so long, these episodes. I'm sure you peeps know. I would love it if you could take just a few split seconds of your time to check out my Patreon. I'd be most, most grateful. It would really help us out. We'd need your support. And do you know what? We are grateful for everyone that has so far. Please check it out. And yeah, thanks for watching.
Now shut the fuck up.